While most developers are learning their 10th JavaScript framework, the top 1% are doing something completely different, and it's not what you think. I've been reviewing job applications, interviewing and guiding developers for years now, and there's this one thing that stands out about developers who advance quickly in their careers. They don't follow the usual advice. Learn new frameworks, watch coding tutorials daily, get as many certifications as you can. They don't do that. They understand five things that actually move the needle. And in this video, I'll break down each one, not just theory. I'll show you exactly how to apply these in your day-to-day work. But first, let's talk about what does not work. Learning every new framework. That certainly does not work. Building random projects, watching tutorials every day, that doesn't work either. Getting more certifications, no. See, most developers focus on adding more tools to their toolkit, more languages, more frameworks, more projects. But the developers who get ahead focus on something entirely different: impact. Let me break this down. The first thing these developers understand is system thinking, not just code thinking. When they look at a code base, they don't just see functions and classes. They see how everything connects, how data flows, where things can break. Take any major production incident at tech companies that we've had quite a few this year. The root cause is really about code quality. It's almost always about system interactions. One service affects another, data flows break, systems, timeouts. Understanding how systems work is way more valuable than knowing how to write perfect code. You can write the most beautiful code in the world, but if you don't understand how it fits into the larger systems, it will still cause problems. So when next you get a new task, don't just think about the code you need to write. Think about, how would this affect other parts of the system? Where could this break under load? What happens when things fail? This mindset alone puts you ahead of most developers, but it's just the start. The second thing that sets these developers apart, they understand the business side of technology. Most developers treat business requirements as a distraction. Just let me code. Just leave me to do my thing. But the developers who advance quickly do the opposite. They ask questions about the business impact. They understand what problems they're actually solving, not just the technical problems, the business problems. When someone says, we need user authentication, they ask, why? Why do we need user authentication? Is it for security? Is it for personalization? Is it for user tracking? The answer to this question, or to questions like this, changes everything about how you approach the solution. Now, the third thing is this: the developers who get ahead are strategic about modern tools. And this is huge because the development landscape has completely changed in the last year. We've got AI everywhere now. ChatGPT, Copilot, you're hearing about agents. Every week there's a new AI tool promising to revolutionize coding. But what most developers get wrong is they either ignore these tools completely, or they use them like they're some sort of magic wands. I'll see developers who are not in their learning journey spending hours writing basic operations from scratch, ignoring tools that could do it in seconds. Or worse, I'll see developers copying AI-generated code without understanding what it does. The developers who get ahead use modern tools as amplifiers, not replacements, and they don't just ignore these tools either, or ignore the technological advancements going on around them. For example, when I'm working on a new feature, I can use Copilot to handle routine stuff, maybe basic API endpoints, data validation, or even test cases. This saves me time. But that saves time is what I then spend in understanding the architecture, thinking about edge cases, planning for scale. And it's not just AI tools. There's this whole ecosystem of modern development tools that most people ignore. And you should stop ignoring what's happening around you. And most importantly, you should not let these tools replace your own thinking. Now, you don't need to use every tool out there. You need to understand which tools solve your specific problems. Start with your biggest time wasters. What tasks do you repeat often? What takes up most of your development time? Those are your opportunities to take advantage of modern tools. And the fourth thing is this: the developers who get ahead are masters of technical communication, not just writing docs, although that's part of it. They know how to explain complex technical concepts in simple terms. When there's a production issue, they don't just fix it. They explain what happened, why it happened, and how to prevent it. And they do this in a way that both developers and non-developers understand. They document decisions, not just code. You know, why was this approach chosen? What other options were considered? What trade-offs were accepted? This kind of communication builds trust. It shows leadership. It gets you involved in bigger decisions. And the fifth and final thing is this: the developers who get ahead, they're smart about technical debt. Most developers complain about technical debt, but these developers who get ahead of 99% of the other developers, they use it strategically. They understand that some technical debt is actually good. It lets you move fast when you need to. While other technical debt is toxic, it slows everything down. They know how to tell the difference, and more importantly, they know how to explain the difference to decision makers. Here's how you can apply all this in the next year. Start with system thinking. Every time you work on something, draw out how it connects to other parts of the system. Then add business understanding. For every task, write down the business problem it solves, not the technical problem, the actual business problem. Use tools in a smart way. Yes, use AI, use automation, but use them to handle the routine stuff so you can focus on the bigger picture. Practice explaining technical concepts simply. Find non-technical people and practice explaining what you're working on. If they don't get it, you're not explaining it well enough. And finally, be strategic about technical debt. Don't try to fix everything. Focus on the debt that's actually hurting the business. Do these five things consistently for a year, and you'll be approaching problems in a way that puts you ahead of most developers out there. And this is not just about working more hours. It's about working differently. You can spend the same time, but now you have a different focus. If you found this helpful, hit that like button and drop a comment below telling me which of these five areas you're going to focus on first. See you in the next one.